Over 300 teams start the season with hopes of making it to the NCAA tournament, but only 64 lucky teams received an invitation. These teams start their journey down the road to the Final Four in today's game between the Murray State Racers and the Michigan State Spartans.
Hey, Brad, the NCAA tournament is the reward. After a long season of practices, tough games, and all of those other rigors, the tournament is their pinnacle.
The Spartans should have an easy one tonight, Dick. How do they keep this team from sneaking up on them, though?
Hey, here's my keys for them tonight. First of all, give your big men the ball. Let them attack from down low. Second of all, make sure you take care of the rock. Turnovers kill momentum. And finally, be monsters on the boards. Don't be afraid to get tangled up. Crush the glass.
Well, Dick, let's get this one started and see what happens. They go into the low block. Mary receives the pass. They go inside and now back outside.
I tell you, inside-outside action always works.
He gets the bucket to fall.
This is simply a great play, Brad. Tempo of the game, really important here. You want to establish some good tempo.
Tries for two.
I tell you, once you get deep position like that, it's automatic.
Hastings handles the feed. He up fakes. Looking for a good shot. Looking to move it around the perimeter. 10 seconds to get it off. And our trifecta for the night. Aaron Andrews on the sideline. With Dick Vitale. I'm Brad Nessler. Nice to have you along with us. Great steal. I think the pressure was just too much.
Tremendous pressure. Just enough to force the steal.
He keeps his dribble as they reset. Isolated on the outside. They're working around the arc looking for the open jumper.
Great pressure. Great game. Really explosive.
Off the rim and no good. Showing maturity by waiting for the O to regroup. Gilliam receives the ball. Cross court.
Oh, poor job. Poor job offensively. I'm coaching. He's sitting next to me as an assistant coach. He's pounding the ball to the deck. Where's he going? That's a high post screen close to the lane.
Let's go to the third member of our broadcast team. Here's Aaron Andrews.
Well, guys, both teams seem to be playing very conservative. We're still waiting for one of these teams to throw the first punch, guys.
First one is no good. Misses the second. Collects the rebound. He shoots from right of the circle. Way off target. Patience with the ball as the offense regroups.
Try to go inside.
And they do. They got it on the low block. Perfectly executed. If they can get a score, this place is going to go wild. Now trying to feed the low block. Goes up for two. And in and out.
Brad, I'm afraid to hear this crowd. If they can get a stop on this possession.
He may be in trouble here.
Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards like they have.
Yeah, that helps. He fires it up. The Racers have got to continue to get him the ball.
They need to keep feeding him the ball. It's simple.
Tries a three. Off the rim and no good. Ball goes out of bounds. He stays in control until they regroup the offense. There's a double team waiting there. Gave it up. He stole the ball. Great pressure there.
Fantastic ball pressure. The pressure got to the ball handler, and he lost it.
Down inside. Trying to draw some contact. Basket falls despite the contact. It up. Now the turnaround jumper. In and out. Launches the three. Off the mark. Opportunity for 2-for-1. Trying to feed the low block. Here's a double team. Gave it up. Way out on top. Controlling the ball. Way off target. Jumped in front to take it away. Puts it up, looking for contact. Shot clock is dead. From beyond the arc, off the rim and no good.
Up and inside.
Clinton handles the pass. Kicks it out. The shooting guard takes the pass for the bucket.
Great play to take that to the basket.
At the end of the first half, the Racers are down 4. This one's too close to call here at the end of the first. Dick, do you have a highlight of the half?
There was some nice inside play in the first half. We'll have to see which team continues to pound the ball inside in the second half.
Well, it looks like the teams are just about set for the second half. Let's get back to the action. Murray State is guilty of poor shooting in that first half, and I mean poor shooting, Dick.
I'll tell you one thing, Brad. You're too nice a guy. I know that, but you're too kind. The Wolf was shooting. They're going through the room with any ball games.
Let's check in courtside with Aaron Andrews. Aaron?
Well, Brad and Dick, as you can imagine, both coaches were very intense as I met with them at halftime. They said at this point, it all comes down to playing their game, having fun, and enjoying the moment. Guys?
All right, thanks, Aaron. Can't get the shot to drop. He beats him to the punch defensively.
What a terrific job. Footwork really excellent on a post play.
He's clearly forcing things right now, Dick.
He's taking his team out of the game.
Dumps it in. Dick, he's going to go up strong.
Oh, that's a terrific post play. Didn't waste any time attacking the basket.
The point guard takes the feed. Almost lost a basketball. He shoots from the elbow. Gets it to fall.
The defender is still applying great ball pressure, Brad.
Clinton receives the ball. Jumped in front to take it away. Those long arms trying to get it in front three quarters.
I'll tell you one thing, that big guy down inside, though, is so big that really it's tough to deny him the ball.
Good defensive stance, a spin move.
Well, the key is to beat him to the spot, and he did a great job. He anticipated that spin move.
Wheeler is feeling great out there right now.
And you know what, Brad? I'm excited for him. He's putting on a performance.
Racers have a mismatch in the post.
It's definitely a mismatch.
That's a foul. Dick, how's that backcourt comparison shaping up, do you think?
Hey, Brad, that's a question that these coaches should be asking themselves. How can they, as coaches, get the most out of their guards? Are they quick enough to pressure the opponent, or offensively, can they create off the dribble? To me, it's about finding the weaknesses and attacking them.
The Spartans have a mismatch in the post.
This may be a good opportunity for them, Brad.
Top of the... And has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that blocked shot.
He makes a nice shot fake. That spin move not successful, Dick.
I did a great job on the defense not allowing him to make that turn.
They go inside and now back outside.
I tell you, inside-outside action always works.
Doesn't go. There appears to be a mismatch in the post.
They need to get him the ball there.
He puts it in with contact and all. Let's go courtside. What do you got for us, Aaron?
Well, guys, down here on the sidelines, there is such intensity from both benches. Both coaches are emphasizing shot selection and defensive stops. So important here in the second half.
Thanks, Aaron. Dickey's going to kick it back out there from down on the low block.
I tell you, a post player has to be able to read what the defense gives you.
The point guard receives the pass. Goes out of play. I've seen you out there with pom-poms, Mr. Vitale, but not looking that good.
I'll tell you what, don't look that good. I can't dance like that, baby.
Big finish coming here, partner. I'm not going anywhere.
Hey, down the stretch, there are so many factors that could become the difference maker. Turnovers, missed free throws, rebounding. I wonder what it will come down to in this game.
Wow, did you see the mascot on the last dunk? He was going crazy. He loved it. I loved it. Those are the things that keep me coming back. Love that spirit.
Timeout on the floor. Aaron Andrews, what do you got for us, EA?
Well, at this point in the game, it's about being on the same page. Each player should know what the objective is for the upcoming possession. Offensively, you must know who the number one option is, while defensively, the type of defense you're going to play or whether to foul. Time is of the essence, Brad.
I think she's right about that, Richie. Boy, it's all elbows and shoulders down there, and I think the defense is winning, Dick.
I tell you, doing a great job in post defense. A lot of people don't realize that is an area that has to be taught, and this kid has responded in a positive way.
Now they work it around the perimeter.
I tell you, he missed the post guy. The post guy had the great angle, was locking on a box.
For the deuce. Sweet looking shot.
He is sweet. He really is. Up and inside.
They're working around the arc.
Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
He takes the shot.
The more possessions you create, the better your chances.
Well, now it's just a matter, Dick, isn't it, of clock management here? And again, let's take a look at that State Farm drive of the game, Dick.
Hey, the ability to get to the paint is one thing, Brad, but he also demonstrated the ability to finish as well. That's awesome, baby, with a capital A.
And yet another foul as they're just trying to hang on here. Well, Dick, it's obvious to me that they are starting to heat things up right now.
I'll tell you one thing. They're getting good shots, and they're making them count. They're in the groove, baby. And when they're in the groove, that court looks like an unbelievable Atlantic Ocean instead of a teapot.
Foul, and that stops the clock again. And they continue to foul to stop the clock.
Hey, now it's a matter of clock management, Brad. They have to foul in order to get back in this game.
And yet another foul. And yet another foul as they're just trying to hang on here. He'll go to the line. Makes the front end of the 1-1. No rebounding that.
T.O. called. Hey, we got a barn burner here, baby. I'm thinking last second shot for the win, Mr. Nestler.
I knew this was going to be a dandy, baby.
The lead is down to three. I isolated on the outside. They work it around the arc looking for the open jumper. And they continue to foul to stop the clock. He'll visit the charity stripe. Up and in. Nothing but rim.
They need a basket here to turn this into a one possession game.
You think they switch things around here for the moment, Dick?
I don't think so, but we'll wait and see, Brad.
The lead trickles down to four.
Time is either your best friend or your worst enemy at this point, Brad.
Dick, I think the better team won. We can say that. And it's heartbreak for the other club. But, you know, you got to win it and keep on going to get to that final Monday night in April.
Well, I tell you, won this game, Brad, when you look at it and analyze it, because they really had all the right people shoot the ball at the right moment. They did a terrific job offensively.
Michigan State played exactly the type of game they need to get past their first-round opponent.
Mr. Nesler, if they can execute the way they did today, are you kidding me?